Hello friends, welcome to the VLSI design course. So in previous lecture we have seen how to use the case statement to design a combinational circuit. So in today's session we are going to cover a sequential circuit design using a case statement. So here today we are going to take a state machine example in writing a VHDL code for that particular state machine. So let's start. So for the state machine today we are going to write a VHDL code for a sequence detector. So this one example I am taking, design a 1011 sequence detector using Mealy machine and the non-overlapping concept. So I will recommend, if you want to understand the concept of sequence detector in a better way, like using Mealy machine, Moore machine, what is the concept of overlapping, non-overlapping, so I will recommend you please watch our earlier video where I have covered the state machine and their example as well as the sequence detector examples. So let us start. So as per our sequence, the first input start with the logic 1. Okay. So you know in Mealy machine we are going to write design using the states. So I'm writing here state S0. So initial my state is in S0. Okay. So when valid input logic came, that is here valid input is 1, then it will go to the next state. So when input 1 comes, output is 0, state is S1. Okay. As well as now in S0, if logic 1 comes, we are going next. If logic 0 comes, we have to stay in a same state. So 0, output 0. Now in a S1, if next valid input comes, we are going to the next state, that is S2. Okay. So we are going in a S2 when next valid input is 0, output 0. Now in S1, if 0 comes, we are going next. If 1 comes, we have to stay in a same state. So 1, output 0. Now again from S2, if a next valid input came, we are going to the S3 state, right? That is next valid input is, now 1 came, 0 came, next valid input is 1. So 1, output 0. But in S2, if logic 0 comes, what will happen? It will go to the reset state, that is our initial state S0. Got it? So when 0 comes, output 0, it will go back to the S0. Now in S3, we are going to complete our next valid input signal, that is 1, and output is 1. So that means if input came 1, 0, 1, and again 1 came, it has to output 1. But where it has to go, we will decide. Now as we said, the sequence is a non-overlapping. So expected after the output of this, after detecting the this sequence, output is 1, and because of non-overlapping, again we are looking a 1, 0, 1, 1. So in non-overlapping, we are not considering the last bit for our next sequence. So we are looking a fresh sequence. So it will go to initial state. So in S3, when logic 1 comes, it will go to the S0, 1, output 1. Got it? Now in S3, logic 1 condition is over. Now for what will happen for the logic 0? Now let us see if my sequence came. Now S3, we reach to S2 like this, 1, 0, 1. Now this is in S3 state condition, right? Now let us assume if 0 came. If 0 came, what we have to do, where we have to go, we can go to S2, S1 or S0, but we have to identify where exactly. Now let us see, if we are in S3 state, if 0 came, but these two bits are a valid sequence of our initial sequence, right? 1, 0 is a valid input sequence. Now, then to complete our sequence, we have to look for the 1, 1. 1, 1, output 1. So, we have to find out a sequence or a state where after 1, 1 reaching, output should come 1. So, where this condition is arising, it is arising into S2. So, let's give S3 to S2 when input 0 came, output 0. That means in S2, it came to S2. So we, let us say here we are in S2. Then again if 1 came, we are in S3, right? And again if 1 came, we will go to S0, but output is 1. So that means this is a valid condition for 0 output 0 in case of state S3. Okay. So this is all about the sequence detector. Now to write a VHDL code, we need a entity declaration sections. So what are the input signal and output signal? So here I am taking input as a X single bit, output Y as a single bit, as well as this is a sequential circuit. So I am considering clock is another one input and reset. Why reset? Because we have to start with the initial state S0. So this is sequence detector logic. Okay. So what are the inputs? My X is input, clock is input, reset is input, Y is output. Now what about this reset? So we will give another one signal here. If reset is equal to 1, we should come to the initial state. Else, it will detect a clock and then it will start detecting the sequence. Okay. So this is all about the sequence detector. Let's go back to our ISC and start writing a VHDL code. Okay. So create a new project file, new project. So I'm writing here case state machine example. Okay, this is our project, new project, next, finish. Okay, then add new source file, VHDL module, then case, using case sequence detector. Okay, then next, now as per our entity, what I am going to declare, one is the X input, then clock and the reset, that is the input. Then next is a Y as a output, right? Then just say next, finish. It will, okay, so our project is created with entity declaration X, clock, reset, Y as a out. Now, as we have seen in the sequence detector, there are the states S0, S1, S2 and S3. So to declare these states, we have to define our own user defined data type called as the enumerated data type. So let us first declare these states. So how to declare these steps? We have to use a keyword type, then the data type declaration name, like type underscore declaration. I'm giving the name of that state or data type as a type declaration is, how many states are there? There are S0, comma S1, comma S2, comma S3. Okay. Now, but this data type we have declared, but to use this data type, we need a signal. So I am giving a signal name as a state with a data type of type underscore declare. Okay. So these many declarations we required in while writing a sequence detector code using case statement. Now let us begin. So process, because this is a sequential circuit, so I am writing a process. So what are the sensitivity list signals in process? First is the clock, then reset, as well as the X input. Okay. Now begin. Now we are giving highest priority to the reset, and here we are designing asynchronous reset. So whenever reset is equal to 1 came, we have to, every time we have to go back to the state S0, always S0. Okay. And then accordingly, this input is we have considered as a X, and this output is we have considered as a Y. Okay. So let's begin. If reset is equal to 1, then correct. If reset is equal to 1, what we have to do? We have to stay in a state S0, right? We have to stay in a state S0, and output Y is equal to, still here it is 0, right? Now else if, now I am detecting a clock on every rising edge. So clock tick event and clock equal to 1, then we'll check the input condition. So here we are writing a statement like if clock tick event and clock equal to 1, then we are going to write a case statement, case state is. Now when we are in a A0 state, what we have to do? We have to check. Okay, right now suppose we are in a A0 state. Now then we have to check the input condition, x value, and accordingly we have to make the output y. So if x is equal to 0, we are in a state A0 itself and output is also 0. So let's write it how we are going to write. If x is equal to 0, then state is equal to what? A0, and output y is 0, right? So this is the condition. Else means if x is equal to 1, what will happen? State is equal to S1, right? And output y is also still 0, correct? Then end if, right? So this completes our first state logic. Okay, so in first state it will come here, it will detect if x is equal to 0, stay in the same state, output is 0, but if x is equal to 1, go to the next state, output is 0. So same thing we have written here. Now again we will repeat this thing for all other conditions. Now we are in a S1 state. Now suppose we are in a S1 state. So if we are in a S1 state and if x is equal to 0, what is the condition? If we are in a S1 state, if x is equal to 0, we are going into next state S2, output is 0. Okay. So if we are in a S1 state, x is equal to 0, state is equal to S2, output is 0. Else we are in, if x is equal to 0, we have to stay in the same state S1, output is 0. So this completes our state 1 S1 condition, right? Now if we are in a S2, if we are in S2 and if x is equal to 0, state is S0, output is 0, and if it is 1, we are going to the S3, output is 0. So if x is equal to 0, S0 state, output is 0. Else if x is equal to 1, we are going to the S3, output is 0. Then last condition, when we are in a S3, if x is equal to 0, we are going to S2. If x is equal to 0, we are in S3 state. X is equal to 0, we are going to the S2. Output is 0. But when input is equal to 1, output also 1, and going to the state S0. So let's finish it. If x is equal to 0, S2, output 0. If x is equal to 1, our sequence is detected. We are going to S0. And here output is 1. Got it? So here sequence 1011 detected. Correct? So this completes our if case condition, all the valid condition. Then when others clause, I'm just writing a null, then end case, right? Then we have to end the end if and then end process, right? This end if for this, whatever the we have used for the reset, for that we have used this end if. Okay, near case. Okay, done. Just check this in synthesis of this design. Just look at it. Synthesis RTL schematic. So clock reset x is input, y is output, So it creates an FSM. If you see here, it creates, so using a case statement, it creates always a finite state machine. So whatever the finite state machine we have used here, the same machine is created over here. And particularly the output is connected with, because of your use a clock signal, that is clock tick event and clock equal to 1. So at output it creates a D flip flop with clock. Okay, D flip flop, and the output logic is connected as per the implementation. So like this, FSM is implemented. So let's go back to the simulation and check whether how we are going to detect the sequence and whether output is coming or not. So we are going to verify the functionality of our sequence detector. Okay, so it's opening. Okay, so restart it. We'll give highest priority to the reset, then clock, then X and Y. Okay, so let's start with the reset. If reset is equal to 1, okay, we are in a output Y is equal to 0, state is equal to always 0. So unless, whenever we are, if reset is equal to continuously 1, and it is asynchronous reset, so it will not depend on the clock. So let's force the clock also 0, my leading edge is 0, next trailing edge is 1, and the period I am taking 1 microsecond. Okay, so if you observe here, even the clock is coming, we are in a still state S0. Why this is? Because this reset is before the clock, so it is an asynchronous reset. So to understand the concept of asynchronous and synchronous reset, please go back and watch our video design of asynchronous D flip-flop as well as the synchronous D flip-flop design or writing a VHDL code. So there I have explained better way how to write a code for the asynchronous and synchronous reset. So simply in asynchronous reset, it gives the highest priority to the reset signal and before the clock. So when reset is equal to 1, it will not check the clock, nothing it will check. It will directly give state is equal to S0 and Y is equal to 0. So same thing is happening here. Now if reset is equal to 0, that means it will come in else part, right? It will come in else part, and then it will detect a clock, and then it will enter into the, it will check the input X. So let us force X is equal to 0 and check it where it is going. Okay. Now on the rising edge, if reset is equal to 0, see the sequence. If reset is equal to 0, it will come here. It will detect the clock tick event and clock equal to 1, that it detects rising edge. Then it came into the state, already state is equal to S0. So it is right now, it in the state, our state is in S0. So state is our in S0. Then it will check the input X. Now if X is equal to 0, still state in S0 and Y is 0. Now we'll change X is equal to 1 and then check whether it is going next. So let's change X is equal to 1. Okay, run. So if X is equal to 1, on the rising edge of the clock, the state is going to the S1, right? If X is else, this else means X is equal to 1, state is equal to S1, Y is equal to 0. Right now we are in S1. If X is equal to 0, then it will go to the S2. Now what we'll complete our sequence. Now X is equal to 1, then we'll give 0, then 1, 1, and try to finish our sequence, and then randomly we'll try the different input sequence. So my first input came 1, okay, then I'm going to give X is equal to 0, then run it. It is going to the S2, 1, 0. Now we are in a S2, right? We are in a S2, 1, 0. We are in S2. If again 1 came, it goes to the S3. So let's force X to the logic 1. It has to go to the S3, correct? So here input sequence, if you check here, 1 on the rising edge, 1 detected. on next rising is 0 detected, on next rising is 1 detected. Now if you force again 1, so we'll continue, output should come 1 because our sequence is completed. 1 0 1 1 means sequence should complete, output should come 1 and it should go to the state S0. So let's run it once again. Let's see. See here, sequence is detected 1 0 1 1, right? 1 1, output is 1, correct? Output becomes 1 and we are in S0 state. We are in a S0 state, correct? Now we are in a S0 state, and if again logic 1 comes, what will happen? Correct? Here we reach to the S0 state. S0 state, if logic 1 comes, if this 1 came, it should go to the next state, S1. So let's check it. So I am again running it. So input is 1. We are going to the, see, on this rising edge, input is X is 1. So immediately output Y becomes 0. Immediately output Y becomes 0. Input is X. X is equal to 1. Output is equal to 0. And state is S1. State is S1. Now let us run for more time. If we are in S1 state, but still input 1 came. So if you see, if you observe here, the state is always S1. State is always. So many times, if you come more and more time, my state is in S1. Now, so that means if X is equal to 1, it is staying in the same state, same state, same state. Now if 0 comes, let's see. If X is equal to 0, what will happen? It will go to the next state. Yes, it went to the S2 state, and output is 0. Okay. Now we are in S2 state. If 1 comes, we have to check where it is going. So let's force X is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 and run it. So it is going to the S3. Now we have to check the another condition we have explained during example. 1 0 1, and we are in S3, if 0 comes, where it is going? It has to go to S2, and subsequently if it is 1 1 came, output should come 1. So that condition right now we are going to check. So we are in S3. If X is equal to 0, let's run it. So it went to S2 to again S0 because I have run it 2 times. Okay. So make it again fast. Force 1. Zero. S2 again 1. Now in S3, now if you make again force constant 0, right now we are in a S2. Now if you see the previous sequence 0 1 0 1, so no output is always 0. Now if 1 0, right now in S2 state, and if logic 1 came subsequently 2 times, let's see what will happen. 1, so again it will go to the S3 state, and if again 1, output is 1 and S0 state. So that means it detects the sequence 1 0 1 1. So this means our this condition is satisfied. So like this you can write a FSM very easily using a case statement. I hope you understood the concept of writing a VHDL code using state machine. So thank you.